it's Corey. Today I am going to show you how I got this bomb look with the new Morphe 35B Lisa Frank collab. Stunning. Okay, like if you were wanting me to give a bad review, I'll just give it to you now in the first 30 seconds. You're not getting that out of me. You should go to a different channel because this is a freaking game changer. This is wild. So stay for that. Before I get into that, I just want to say thank you so much to everyone that has reached out to my last video. That was a super hard emotional video to make and very stomach turning to make sure that I was still very professional and confidential with people that were involved, not giving too much, but still giving my side. And like the feedback I've got has been a lot and it's been so positive. So I know the little clickbait makes y'all watch that video, but I'm glad that that video got a good little sight. I think that's everything. Literally, I'm just like on cloud nine that this look is so bomb and you all are about to see that and it was caught on camera. And I almost didn't do it. I almost just stayed on the couch and played Animal Crossing. But no, I was like, I'm gonna record a video, and I did. And like, this is like payback blessing for recording this video. Let's get this started. First things first, I finally wash and brushes this giant cup. Girl gang, I finally washed some brushes, and here's the sad news for me, not you, there's a whole other jar. Someone like said to me, like, I have two brushes, why do you have so many? And look around, why do I have so many of everything? Like, that's my answer. I have bought so much stuff, and I currently have two of the like big items with me. The next one I was like, I'll just save it for when it arrives and do a video with that. Ulta Black Friday, hopefully you didn't miss that. By the time this video gets posted, it will be over. And then the return of the 35B Morphe X Lisa Frank, I got that. So I'm going to open what I got and give you a little eye look and be done. It's also Thanksgiving my day when I'm recording this. It's 8 o'clock at night. I didn't go anywhere, but I did do my hair with this amazing Ulta tutorial. Literally one of the best hair tutorials, like advice I've ever gotten in my hair. So I got this Eva NYC hairspray. It's a 10-in-1 primer. I love this. I've been using this for years. I love it. It does so much for you. Daily dose of vitamins, nutrients, multitasking formula, detangles, reduces frizz, strengthens, softens, cuts, dry in time, adds shine, nourishes, smooths, and protects against thermal and UV damage. It smells so good. I highly recommend this. I put it on my hair, wet or dry, just all over. Get it in there. Is that a little blonde peekaboo? No one really knows because I just kind of left it as is because I wasn't super in love. But I have three hair parts. So that's why you see like this really strong blonde over here. In the center, it's actually all black, which is my favorite look of it. And on this side is this lighter brown. I do think it looks cohesive when it's all down still together fine, but I just don't love the tones that came out because my hair is really stubborn. So you saw me in my last video use these NYX little lip glosses. I wanted the other ones, and honestly online, I couldn't tell which ones were which color because they looked very similar in the swatch, but one is definitely a pink undertone and one is a gold undertone. So I just went ahead and finished the set and go. I now have all three. So this one is Power Trip and this one is Left On Red. I got this Makeup Revolution London palette, also called the Revolution. This giant ass mirror and these beautiful warm colors, shimmers, mattes, burgundies. It just drew my attention, so I got it. I literally had never seen it before. Then this Big Mama. This is literally huge. Giant. There is three prints. This dropped on Tuesday. I happen to just be wide awake, so I bought mine at 2 a.m. I'm so glad I got the one I wanted. I've been checking just, I'm like astonished. Have I ever used that word on my channel? Astonished that these have not sold out yet. I don't know. Like, there was literally such a hype online. I don't know if they actually like planned well for once, but still checking like as of yesterday, 2 days after launch, and they still were in stock of all the different ones. There's the tiger, there's the unicorns, and then there's the alien. And I just feel like the tiger was the most iconic like staple I remember from childhood. So that's why I got the 35B with the tiger. Lisa Frank also has a TikTok that has not popped off, but she had one video go viral. So I mean, if you want to see bright colorful things, you can check out Lisa Frank's TikTok. You can also check out mine. This baddie, it's like a little notebook. So we open here, this is gonna drop. We have our giant mirror, and even has a spot where you can sign like this palette belongs to, like how Lisa Frank, so you write your name inside of a notebook saying who owns this cute little mirror. Love all the rainbow colors. When this first got announced, there was a ton of shade about this being the original 35B and just getting a new name slapped on it. But what we're not giving the credit to is the original 35B has been long canceled. Even before I got into makeup, they stopped making that. And which is sad because it's such a great color story. And so I think they tried to kind of remake that color story with the James Charles collab with Morphe, but it still wasn't the 35B that like everyone was dying to have. And I wanted it so bad, but then I just kind of let it die off because like I said, it was long gone by the time I started doing makeup. So when I saw those comments, I was like, yeah, they literally said it is the 35B, but they put Lisa Frank collab on the packaging. And the 35B doesn't exist anymore. Well, now it does, but it didn't. So what are you mad about? If you already have it, don't get it. But people like me who always wanted it, I can now get it, which I did. So today I'm gonna do a little eye look with Miss Lisa and give you my thoughts along the way. So I just went ahead and put my brows on and threw some tape down. But I'm gonna use the AOA Studio Balm Skin Recovery to nourish us while we wait. So my lips are not nearly the size of what I would want. Am I ever gonna get lip injections? No, because I'm terrified of needles. When I look back at old photos, I don't know if it's the way I used to smile or hold my mouth, but my lips look noticeably bigger than what I remember. So big. I'm gonna reach into Playtime Kittens. I'm gonna do that on a M518 fluffy brush, color True to Pan. I didn't even prime my lid using this Pretty Vulgar eyeshadow primer. Can we talk about how much better that is doing? I just did Vaseline every single day on those spots before bed. See if I can use this mirror and y'all still get a good look. So I'm just starting this out as a transition shade. First dip, my opinion is it is the color of the pan. This is obviously a lighter shade, so I'm gonna go in for a second one. I'm going all the way out to that tape. Definitely in pan, it's not meant to be like a wow color. It's meant to be a little transition shade. I do think it's doing its job. It is like a pure matte. It's a little bit more dusty than I feel like most Morphe mattes are. Then on an M411, this short little tapered brush, I'm gonna grab the shade Lollipop. And I'm gonna put that smack dab in my crease. Can you see all that kickback? Better mean it has a whole lot of pigment. That giant palette is just so heavy. Like, this is heavy to hold to be. Ooh! Did you just see all that fall rain on my parade? It's all from the same brush, same dip in. I just could tell there was a lot, so I wanted to give her a moment to figure her out. Definitely a palette we recommend doing our base makeup last. It turns into a very magenta. Blends really nicely. That is color payout. Take notes. Brush that had Playtime Kittens in it, just pulling her up. I feel like that is the number one mistake, and I won't lie, sometimes I have a harsh line. Like, it does take extra blending, extra time, is when we don't put our colors together. Like, we just accept this harsh line with no color movement. It just looks so much more cohesive and like blended, blown out, when we just go back in with our transition shade and pull up closer to the brow bone. And granted, I know I have a big space to play with. Like, I do. A lot of people don't have that. So if you don't, I understand sometimes. But even then, get you a little tiny blending brush and pull those colors up, honey. Wow. That's wild. I'm gonna grab an R39 little flat fluffy brush. So far, I've been able to do this for everyone, closing it halfway. I'm gonna grab Violet and Velvet. Same bold pigment. If this is, I'm not gonna say it's the same formula because I feel like Morphe formulas have changed over the time that just I've been into Morphe. And like I said, this palette was out long before me, the original 35B. I just think it's wild. Obviously this palette was like hugely desired for a reason. So I bet this palette, like back in the day, what payout pigment was, like they can only imagine with the new formula. And I'm just pressing in and up into that lower outer corner and into the crease. Wow. It just literally blend so nicely and the color is like there. So I really want to use this Prancing Unis, but I'm a little nervous it's not gonna be as light as what I'm looking for because the colors have been so true to what they say. Looking at my options here. I don't want to mess this up. This looks so beautiful. Have you all seen that little Desperado? And then they come through like, boom! A little song is in my head. I just don't know how y'all do transitions like that so well. I click a button in iMovie and it gives me a transition. So I think my game plan is, Lord, don't fail me. I'm gonna take this Morphe flat round head, not a number on it. I'm gonna grab Prancing Unis. I once swiped her because I just wanna lay this just nice little outline down for one of the shimmers to brighten her up. I also threw a little concealer in the inner corner for when I was cutting out my brows because my inner corner is so dark. I've been very open about like the darkness of my under circles and what they've done in their life, but it's gone into that area. And so I just just put a little concealer on there, and I think I like how it brightened that up. Okay, now that I have that thin little base on to really pop this, I'm gonna use the same brush. I'm gonna go into Rainbow Majesty, which is this shimmer. I really wanna grab that one, but that one's a little bit more pink than the I was going for. My wrist hurts from holding up this giant palette. Just got a fat drop of glitter on my face. These little rounded flathead brushes are just so nice to make like a faux cut crease. It's obviously a cut crease. We don't have to go through like all the work of making a cut crease when you can just make these nice solid lines. Okay, now I'm gonna use the trusty finger to just really pack that in there. Oh my gosh. Wow, literally all I got. The R39 that had the violet and velvet, didn't put anything new on it. Pulling colors together. I think I'm gonna be wild. And I'm gonna grab Priscilla, the pink that I was talking about. And I'm just dusting her on. Don't we feel like this hair like fits with the 90s? We got the little crimp going. Living for this, okay? Just to deepen that outer corner just a little bit more. I'm gonna grab this Morphe pointed round brush. And I actually have to flip this over. Panda Painter seems a little blue, so I'm gonna go into the one right next door to it. Max Splash. So I think it's just like a matte black. We're gonna get a little bit of her just on this outer corner. We love a good deep end. Small little wishy-wishies. Wow, the beauty. Just taking my time to blend it. I'm grabbing another little bit longer but clean pointed flat brush just to give that extra buff but not add any more color disbursement that I was not going for. Wow. I can't get over it. I'm gonna grab Rory, which I think it's like the first lightest shimmer we have. Like we're gonna be a little bit of a champagne. And we're gonna throw her right under that brow. See that little moment we're giving her? Lisa said I never left. Okay, I'm gonna remove my tape. That needs to air dry. That is sweaty. Wow. Dollar store tape, y'all. Okay, I'm gonna finish the rest of my face and come back and do the final touches with Miss 35BLF Lisa Frank. And I will give my final thoughts if you couldn't already tell. Should've got some little butterfly clips for this video, but I don't plan ahead like that. I'm gonna throw on my under eye touches. I wanted to get back on camera before I did that. So my little short, stocky, dirty black brush, I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna go into Violet Velvet and I'm gonna go on the bottom lash line. And we're gonna connect our masterpieces. Not all the way, just a little bit shy of center. Going back and forth and buffing those two out. I'm gonna go back into that black Max Splash. Hit that outer corner, same brush. Then the little brush we used to give her a little brow moment, I'm gonna go in to, I don't think I said it, it was called Rory, my little highlight color. And I'm going to build this outer corner. Like, typically I don't go that bright, but for what I'm about to do, you're gonna be like, whoa! And who knows, I may even come back for more. Another moment that you're gonna be like, WTF. I'm gonna grab this JH39 tiny little brush. I'm gonna go into Angel Kitten. I've never seen a truer blue. And that little spot we left open, squeeze her in there. Oh my gosh. She's so cute. Literally so cute. Okay, now when I come back, I'll be actually put together. So this is the finished look. My little gray hairs just stay popping through. I have gray hairs, I say it. Anyways, this look came through door open, door closed, door through windows, all of it, through it, went through it. Like those are my words. Like I, what? Okay, so wrapping this up, you already know I don't do like 5 stars or whatever, but like I 100% approve of this palette. My biggest complaint is like my wrist really is like tired. This palette is super heavy. I just think because the magnet compact thrown into just a giant palette and then throw the weight of the mirror on there, it is a lot of just literal weight holding it. Oh my god, that's crazy that both my hands fit under there. I highly recommend highly. In regards to like everyday use, no. But if you're looking for color, if you missed out on the 35B like I did growing up, then this is your chance and I would not miss out on it. I'm just like stunned. I don't have words. Do you have words? Because I don't have words. No. Okay, that's it. That's my feelings. The giveaway's down in the description box. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And I did go ahead and use the power trip on the center of my lips. Thank you so much. Bye, potatoes.